Dr. Dixon, would you be able to tell us what some common age-related eye ailments are?
The commonest thing would be cataract. If you age long enough, you're going to have a cataract. They may be mild with no symptoms. They may be moderate. They could be quite severe. They're probably still one of the commonest causes of blindness throughout the world, as we know it. Fortunately, in North America, we have the luxury of getting them treated, and it's not a major problem. That's probably the commonest. The next commonest would be age-related macular degenerative changes, where you have an aging process going on in the central part of your retina, where you can no longer process the information coming to your eye, and you get a blurred image in the middle of what you're looking at. And a third concern would be glaucoma, where you have pressure that the eye cannot withstand, and it puts pressure on the optic nerve that damages the sight. And that often has no symptoms at all, and it's discovered on a routine eye exam. The predisposing features are a family history of the same process of glaucoma. Some diseases are associated with glaucoma more frequently, and sometimes your background of origin is significant as well, because some ethnic groups are more prone to getting glaucoma than others.
Other than diabetes, what diseases might predispose someone to glaucoma?
Injury would be probably one of the commoner ones. Industrial injury, home injuries. Cataract, again, can be associated with it, but diabetes would be a predisposing feature as well that should be screened as well.
What are some signs and symptoms of age-related macular degeneration?
Usually patients notice that they are having trouble focusing, so as I'm looking right at your face, I might notice that your nose is blurry or that your ear's blurry or that I'm trying to read a paragraph and the middle piece of a word is missing. These would probably be the commonest first presenting features.
What are signs and symptoms of cataracts?
Generally, there are very few symptoms. Patients get a generalized decrease in their color discrimination in what they can see clearly, and it comes on so slowly they may not know they have it. And often their first clue is that they fail their driving test. Or they go to match their outfit to go out for the day and they find they've got a black skirt and a navy blue sweater. And their children say, "You used to be a fashion plate. What's changed?" And they say, "Well, I thought they were both navy blue."
What are some general tips to keep our eyes healthy, Dr. Dixon?
Well, the first biggest clue would be to stop smoking. Smoking damages the retina. We know it predisposes to macular degeneration. It enhances the onset of cataract. So two extra good reasons besides your general health to give up smoking. Adequate intake of green leafy vegetables, like our parents used to tell us to eat, are very important. They, again, documented that macular degeneration progression may be slowed if you eat your veggies. And having routine checkups, particularly if you have a family history of eye disease, is important. If you've got glaucoma in your family, if you have somebody with cataracts, macular degeneration, it would be worth definitely having your eyes checked. Certainly by the time you're 45 or 50. If you have diabetes, there's a routine for getting them checked routinely every year or every 2 years, depending on the type of diabetes that you have. So those are the main features.
Where might somebody find out more information about eye health in general, especially these topics that we've covered?
Well, a lot of offices have information pamphlets available. We're offering anybody who wants to come to our forum on the 17th of October information about the three main features, that's macular degeneration, glaucoma, and cataracts. We're going to cover those topics, and people are welcome to attend free of charge. We'll have some information available. They can contact the CNIB, who just produced a wonderful pamphlet that we hope, well, it's really a book, that we hope they'll have online by the time our conference comes. And they can access general information questions about eye conditions of any kind that they'd like to access.